Antarctica, the last great unexplored wilderness on Earth. Experts suggest we know more about the surface of the Moon than we do about the southernmost continent of our planet. And surprisingly little is understood about what may lie beneath the 6 million square mile network of ice sheets. But could its greatest mystery be that below this frozen wasteland lies the site of the fabled island of Atlantis? According to legend, Atlantis was a mythical island subcontinent inhabited by a race of people far more advanced than our own. It was first mentioned in the writings of Greek philosopher Plato in 360 BC. He described a vast network of awe-inspiring cities whose inhabitants possessed great knowledge of science, astronomy, and engineering. Their technological advancements were far beyond those of other cultures and civilizations of the time, and they were able to use their superior knowledge to build great temples, citadels, and libraries before a series of natural catastrophes besieged the island and sank it beneath the waves. Its exact location has long been speculated, with historians proposing a wide array of sites across the globe, from a seabed just off the coast of Greece to a sand-covered dust bowl in the depths of the Sahara Desert. Many other locations have also been proposed, from as far east as Japan to sites off the tip of South America. But recent images sent back to Earth by NASA satellites suggest that, contrary to popular belief, the location of this once great civilization lies deep below what is now one of the most inhospitable landscapes on our planet. Skeptics tend to reject any theories linking Atlantis to Antarctica, primarily because of its hostile climate. The temperature rarely climbs above freezing, even in the height of summer, and can drop to minus 70 in the depths of winter. In addition, 98% of the continent is covered in a sheet of ice at least a kilometer deep. But what if there was evidence to prove that Antarctica wasn't always the hostile continent it is today? Scientists are confident that many years ago, the ecosystem of Antarctica was very different, a theory supported by evidence which confirms that the region was once covered in lush flora and fauna. Pollen from tropical palm trees and other exotic plant life has been found within ice samples taken from the region, and several maps from antiquity, including the famous Piri Reis map, depict an Antarctica without the icy layer that now blankets the area. Adding further weight to the theory of what lies beneath the ice, paleontologists recently unearthed the fossilized remains of an ancient lizard-type reptile that stalked the forests and lowlands of Antarctica long before it became the frozen tundra we see today. But how could the climate of Antarctica have changed so dramatically? Experts have theorized that movements in the Earth's crust, known as crustal displacement, mean that it is highly probable that Antarctica was completely ice-free only a few thousand years ago. The theory asserts the idea that the outer shell of the Earth can shift significantly over a relatively short period of time, moving continents and land masses around the globe. In Antarctica's case, this crustal displacement caused the entire area to shift over 2,000 miles towards the South Pole, a move that caused its climate to change fundamentally. The consequences of a crustal displacement are monumental. As the Earth's crust ripples over its interior, the planet is shaken by incredible earthquakes and floods. The sky seems to fall, the sun appears to rise and set over an altered horizon until the crust finally grinds to a halt. Beneath the surface of the ocean, earthquakes generate massive tidal waves and overwhelm submerged coastlines. Some regions shift to warmer climates, whilst others, propelled into the polar zones, suffer the direst of winters. In Antarctica's case, the crustal displacement caused the entire region to shift over 2,000 miles towards the South Pole, a move that has caused a devastating change in its climate. Whatever managed to survive this initial catastrophic event was forced to adapt, migrate, or die. So prior to the continental shift, it would seem perfectly logical that Antarctica could have provided the perfect setting for many as yet undiscovered civilizations. Could Atlantis have been one of them? The legend of Atlantis has persisted across thousands of years, and today it is used as a fantastical setting for countless movies, TV shows, and even a Broadway musical. Jules Verne's classic novel, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, includes a trip to a sunken Atlantis, and authors were using it as an inspiration as far back as 200 years ago. But is there evidence of Atlantis's existence prior to this? Historians across a variety of fields and disciplines have found that communities and cultures separated by centuries and thousands of miles repeatedly refer to a utopian civilization made up of people of immense skill, intellect, and wisdom. References to this can be found in the writings not only from ancient Egypt and ancient Greece, but also in the myths and legends of the Native and Central Americans. Their folklore speaks of a powerful race of people who lived on a white island below what is now the continent of South America. They possessed superior knowledge and abilities and originated from shining cities of white light. The fables go on to explain that this race of people disappeared almost overnight when their city sank beneath the ocean waves after a series of natural catastrophes, leaving no trace that they ever existed. The consistency and similarities of these accounts from unconnected and isolated cultures across the world seem to point to the undeniable fact that sometime between the 4th and 12th millennium BC, there was an extremely advanced civilization on Earth. These people were in possession of great knowledge of navigation, cartography, and astronomy. Their technical advancements were way ahead of other cultures that would appear after them. The lost civilization clearly preceded our modern society by tens of thousands of years, and many people firmly believe that this civilization could have been Atlantis. But is there any actual physical evidence to prove this long-lost island ever existed? In 2016, images of Antarctica taken from space revealed what appears to be the top of an astounding pyramid-like edifice protruding up from the ice and snow-covered expanse. And if the resolutions are correct, this pyramid appears to be four times larger than the Great Pyramid of Giza, which at the time of its construction was believed to be the largest man-made structure on Earth. Despite the initial excitement at this discovery, scientists were quick to dismiss these images as nothing more than the peaks of a mountain range hidden below the thousands of miles of ice sheets that make up this frozen continent. However, further satellite images have also revealed what looks like the remains of a once great city, with stairwells and city walls visibly encased within the frozen wastelands. These images appear to confirm the idea that Antarctica was once the ideal environment for a race of people responsible for creating such structures. And if so, who were these people? And more importantly, what happened to them? Ancient Greek texts refer to the inhabitants of Atlantis as half-god, half-man, bound with vastly superior intellects and knowledge who were at the forefront of mathematics, science, and astronomy. The fact that the Atlanteans were so much more evolved than their contemporary societies at the time has led to the suggestion that they may not have been human at all. Could the discovery of Atlantis finally confirm the long-held belief that extraterrestrials not only visited Earth, but were also instrumental in the evolution of the human race? Ancient texts from all the major civilizations throughout history make detailed reference to being visited by beings from heavens, and in the case of Atlantis, it's possible that these beings spliced their DNA with early humans to create a super race of people who then shared their knowledge and wisdom with other cultures and civilizations around the world. This would certainly explain how mankind made such an evolutionary jump from cave-dwelling vertebrates to intellectual beings capable of understanding complex mathematics and engineering. But if the inhabitants of Atlantis were so advanced, how could they simply disappear and leave little or no trace that they were ever here? In all the accounts of Atlantis throughout antiquity, each one ends with the sudden and total destruction of the region in a very short period of time. Reports indicate that the vast subcontinent was hit by a series of massive earthquakes and eruptions that triggered tsunamis big enough to completely submerge the entire civilization beneath the waves, virtually wiping out an entire race of people in the process. This great environmental catastrophe is also thought to have been the basis for the biblical tale of Noah and the Great Flood, an event that is referred to across many cultures. These accounts of the destructive natural forces that destroyed Atlantis are also consistent with the theory that this once great civilization did indeed fall victim to crustal displacement. Historical records suggest that after the destruction of Atlantis, a few survivors that remained were forced to flee across the world to be subsumed into civilizations which were far less advanced than their own, and stripped of anything tangible that could prove their origins. If this is the case, it appears logical to conclude that the ancestors of the people of Atlantis are walking amongst us today, completely unaware of their amazing genetic heritage. Perhaps the secrets of these half-human, half-alien superbeings are still there, preserved under the ice of Antarctica, suspended in a frozen time capsule, waiting to be discovered. That might explain why Antarctica remains one of the most fiercely contested areas of land on the planet. During World War II, one of the German key objectives was to establish a naval base in Antarctica, and rumors have persisted for years that Hitler had several teams of scientists researching the region for evidence of the existence of Atlantis. In recent history, several countries have tried to lay claim to the icy continent, and even now, virtually every global superpower has at least one research base near the South Pole. And yet, despite this presence, we are supposed to believe that the vast majority of Antarctica remains unexplored, officially at least. Archaeological research on the continent has been sporadic, and the findings of such digs have been shrouded in mystery. Reasons for this inactivity include the difficulties in accessing the region, the expense required to set up such facilities, and the extremities of the climate. However, given that governments have been able to conduct in-depth explorations on other planets, the idea that Antarctica is either too cold or too costly to investigate further appear unconvincing. Indeed, recent undercover reports have discovered a number of world leaders from across the globe have been secretly visiting Antarctica. Whilst the official reasons for these visits is to witness the effects of climate change, there are persistent rumors that it is to view recently unearthed relics and artifacts from a lost civilization which bear a striking similarity to that of Atlantis. Unsurprisingly, this evidence and information remains off limits, and any attempts to share these findings is being suppressed at the highest level. Whatever the truth is, the evidence for Antarctica as the site of Atlantis continues to grow. And if the temperatures of the South Pole continue to rise and ice caps recede further, then perhaps in the not too distant future, Atlantis will finally give up its secrets.